Hello guys, hope you are all well. Welcome back to another video here on Affinity Racing. Something a little bit different, as I've decided to just capture a raw race, so without the kind of edited and chopped together and you know, kind of talking over the top, commentary over the top. Decided to go with just purely a total raw race, and we've hit quite lucky here actually, as I've managed to capture or decide to do this on a race where I've actually got second P2 from qualifying time. So I did just manage to beat my quali time by a tenth or two. So I was originally at a 128 or a 128.8 or a 128.9. So we've just managed to improve that, which is pretty good going. It's bumped us up a couple of positions from where we've previously been qualifying. And the decision that I now have to make in the next 15 seconds is whether or not I'm going to go start on the hard or start on the medium. Oh well, there we go. Decision made for us. I've run out of time. Looks like we're starting on the medium. So we'll see if... we kind of not really know, unless we can judge by pace, whether the chap in P1 there is starting on the mediums or the hards. But we do have to use both in this race, so deciding when to pit may be triggered by the movements of other drivers on the grid. But we shall see. Now hopefully this does work, as the last race that I've just tried to capture, my cam link actually went a little bit haywire and just recorded a frozen screen. 20 odd minutes, so that wasn't very good, but we'll see how we get on with this one. I will say before we start, if you would be ever so kind as to drop a like, why not, and subscribe. It really does help out the channel. Otherwise, you can also visit affinityracing.co.uk, check out the merch store and all that good stuff. That equally helps out the channel just as much. So let's see how we get on with this. We're going to jump straight into the slipstream, so we're going to have to move across see how we manage to get on. So I'm going to close the gap, close. We're not, probably not, I don't know, going to go for a lunge into turn two here, but we are kind of going to have to think a little bit defensively as well in terms of the guys behind us. We have built up, frankly, already a second gap, so that's not bad going. A little bit too wide into that corner there, so he's already gained himself a 1 second gap to us, just as we've gained it from the guys behind. Now, judging by his qualifying pace, I might take a guess that he is actually on the he might be on the harder tyre, which will certainly make things interesting in terms of pit stops and the likes. He's already ran wide there. Wow, okay. Very interesting. Oh, I need to come off the gas. As does he as well, by the looks of it. We haven't lost too much time there. We're now gaining in the slipstream, which is handy. I wanted to get down on the power a little bit earlier there, but I'm sort of quite hesitant in not knowing where it was that he was going to be going. So let's see. I definitely think that he might be on the harder tyre to start with. Just the race pace just is not there versus his qualifying time. From mistakes of previous races, I am probably braking. I'm braking cautiously in terms of braking a little bit earlier, but perhaps a bit too a bit too conservative on the braking. Let's see if we can close the gap a little bit in the slipstream here. Maybe down to just under 3/10. Still at 3/10, 4/10. He's a little bit quicker to get away as well. knew I had got that wrong. I knew I had got that wrong straight away. Ah, oh, shit. As soon as I turned in there, I just knew that that wasn't right. Unbelievable. He's going to run away with it now. Those two guys up in front. So now it's a case of just trying to push forward while we've got a bit of clean space in front. At least trying to anyways. P2 is about 1.3 seconds behind. So hopefully now and again in the odd corner here and there, it does force P1 to go a little bit defensive, maybe close off a few opportunities here and there and possibly catch back up. Oh, what an absolute nightmare. Wiped out by the death chicane. I knew I'd got that wrong as soon as I started turning in. You could just tell. Right. Let's try not to do the same thing. Oh no! I've done it again. Unbelievable. Oh, well, that's definitely P3 lost. There we are, into P4. Oh god, I think I'm starting to have a bit of a nightmare now. Oh, starting to overthink it. I was getting it absolutely bang on in qualifying as well. It was just the rest of the lap that I needed to actually then match up to the same standard. I was absolutely flying through there. Oh. I mean, to do it once in a race is bad enough, but to do it twice, god. Right, come on, let's start pushing again. Could have done being turned in a little bit earlier there. Oh dearie me, let's see what gap we can close. Those two guys are very, very close though. P1 and 2, very, very close. So, oh, there you go, they've just switched around positions there. So zoom perhaps on the straight or in the slipstream. It's been gained. The position has been gained and switched, so we may have ourselves P3 back if we can stick on the back of this chap yet. Ah! Both of us just getting on down on the power a little bit too early. Or a bit too much. Right, come on. I've already messed that right up. Taking it better. Oh, didn't know which way to go there. We're going to have the inside. We may actually get round to be able to just push out a little bit more. He is going to have the better line out, however. Force him round us. He doesn't have the slipstream, but he may well have the inside line. He's certainly going to have the inside line. I've got to give him it. I've got to give him the space. Oh! But I gave you the space, mate. At least you could have done was return the favour. Not very good, and I've still given the space there and pulled off. He has got himself a penalty. Don't actually know what that was directly for, though. He's not going to serve it here either. We do get a better runoff. We've gone round the outside. Only just about managed it. Now I'm going to have to start to look to pit either this lap or next. And judging by previous races, I have a feeling. Oh dear, I'm too busy looking at the timing board there. Judging by previous races and the pit stops that I've had in terms of timings, I think I want to go one more lap. I am way too hesitant now on that death chicane. Way too hesitant. So the gap between... Let's get around this corner before I start trying to talk. So So the gap between P1 and 2 is 1.3. So it's not quite enough to have to... Well, maybe it is, maybe it isn't. You might want to go defensive just to play things super safe. As long as I can keep chipping away and just start catching up. Oh, I need to keep on the brakes a little bit more. Just trail braking a little bit on that corner just as we're turning in. There we are, that's about as good as I'm going to be able to take that. Lovely jubbly, right, come on. So I think the end of this lap, definitely going to have to look to pit. Gap between those two in front, still 1.2. Ah, nearly. Oh, and I've hit the wall. Oh, dear me. That death chicane is causing absolute havoc for me today. It's terribly taken as well. Absolutely horrifically taken. Right. Onto the hard tyres. The guys around have also pitted in front and behind, which is might be helpful, but however they have gone now onto the medium by the looks of things, so we'll gain a little bit of time of course when in front pit. That was another corner that was taken pretty well in qualifying, and I do not seem to be doing it right now. Down to fourth. You can stick in fifth on the mediums. And I feel anyways that just dropping down to fourth on the hard tyres just to help try and get a couple more revs in the rotation there. Jesus, what a nightmare of a race. I don't think I could have been much worse if I tried. That was about as close as I ever wanted to be getting to that to that wall. Right. Oh dear. P2 into the pits. He's gone onto the hard tyres, so he's pitted a lap later than I have. And it looks as if he's going to come out of the pits before us as well, long before us. Come on, let's start closing the gap. If you look to the far right hand side of your screen, you will actually see an apex there. Now and again, I get close to it. It is a rarity, and we do have to actually phone the local gazette up when it does happen, just to let them know. David hit the apex again this month. That might explain a lot. I didn't realise I had the brake value set back in front. I don't know. Why would I have done that? Right, okay, so P2's gone from... Is he held position? I'm not quite sure what's happening there. I couldn't tell if they'd switched positions or not. I wasn't paying too much attention, but it looked as if it almost did. Have they or not? I don't know. Right, either way, they look close enough to be, again, having themselves a bit of a scrap. Just nearly locking up, or just locking up, actually. Of a lip on that chicane, so it helps push you back in and round. Right, come on. Again, we're gaining time a bit here, so that's good news. Oh! There we go. That's definitely the best you're going to see me take that chicane. It was still a bit sloppy, but it wasn't too bad. We didn't crash, basically, is what I'm trying to say there. We did not crash. Just getting out of shape. Right, so there's 4 tenths in it between those guys there, 5 tenths, half a second. That's definitely the kind of space now where you need to start thinking defensive. So let's see if we can catch up in these next couple of laps here. I don't think we're quite going to manage it unless something absolutely drastic happens up front, but... definitely not going to catch up if you keep driving like that. What is going on with me today? Come on. Running wide there. Right. Come on. Let's see how much we can catch up in these next couple of laps here. If anything. Oh dear. Absolutely horrifically. This was not the race to record, I know that much. I'll tell you that much. Right, come on. Push. The gap there now, I think there must have been a mistake from P2, because the gap there now to them, between them, is over a second. So I think it looks as if it's going to be P3 for us. I think we're going to catch up anywhere near P2 to at least apply a little bit of pressure, maybe force a mistake. I don't think it's going to happen. You never do know, do you? Nah. Catching up to the lead again. They go for some last minute, last lap lunges. There's a yellow flag. There is a yellow flag. P2's lost it. Oh, we've got P2. Oh dear. Now I did not see if that was P1 that spinned it, and if they switched around in that time there. I just spotted the yellow flag. And as always, despite it saying no overtaking, we know that that is the best overtaking opportunity we are going to get. So let's just push on a little bit here. I imagine that there must have been a... Although where he's actually binned here, I don't think that that's... There's not a last minute lunge or... That is quite a decent spot to still give space, so... We've got the gap down to 4.8 now. Now, despite us taking that chicane, not the best, I think that's where we've gained a little bit of time there. So he must have taken it even worse. So let's just see. It's last lap. We're definitely not going to be gaining 4.5 seconds in one lap, but let's just see. No, that is not what you want to be doing. Oh, track limit as well. Are we going to have to serve the penalty here, or will it just get added? Yes, it's going to get added. Okay. P2 is about as good as it's going to get after all of that. It certainly is. Let's go all out on the chicane. We're taking it flat out. We are taking it flat out. Let's see. Yeah, we shouldn't have took that flat out. We've got enough of a gap. We'll be all right. We're still gaining time. What's he done then? P3 must have crashed as well. Not to worry. Oh, well, there we are then. We'll take that. We will take P2. It's what we had originally. So we turned up with P2, and we're going to walk away with P2. Not too bad. Well, there we are then. I hope that was an enjoyable little video, an enjoyable race. Not the best result, but I tell you what, to only be 10 seconds off, and let's bear in mind we just spun at the end there, to only have been 7 seconds off or whatever it was, 8 seconds off from the leader after having binned it, what, three times on the death chicane. if I'd maybe just taken that a little bit easier, we may have been on for a slightly better result, but there we are. What can we do apart from keep practicing and go again? We'll celebrate the P2. We will celebrate it, because it's certainly the best result that I've had in this whole week, that's for sure. Really struggled with these two tracks, one of which you've just seen how, that death chicane proving a little bit tricky, but anyways, there we are. Really hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Please like, drop us a like, that's very much appreciated, and even more appreciated is if you hit that subscribe button. Really supports and helps out the channel, especially a new channel just like this one. And if you're feeling extra generous, or you would like to pick yourself up some new racing t-shirts and merchandise, then head over to affinityracing.co.uk. Some cool t-shirts over there, and some new ones on the way too, when we manage to shift the first batch, because there was a lot of money spent on that, and there's still quite a few there. So if you feel like being charitable more than anything else, then head over to affinityracing.co.uk, pick yourself up some merch, and there we are. But in the meantime, guys, I shall catch you in the next one. Thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you soon. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, hit subscribe for future videos, future episodes, and more content just like this. And while you're down there, make sure you check out our description for links to our merch store to get hold of awesome t-shirts just like this one. Any orders on the merch store goes a long, long way at supporting channels just like this. I also think the t-shirts look pretty cool, so make sure you grab what you can, and I shall see you in the next episode.